Okay, so mga kapatid sa Panginoon, good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. Again, this is Pastor Jonathan Pascual from King James Bible Baptist Church coming to you live. So, we're going to study about another book that follows 1 Timothy. So, we are going to study on 2 Timothy, and we're going to deal with the introduction as well as the first chapter, and hopefully that all are in good shape sa lahat po ng ating mga fellow brethren here and abroad, and hopefully that you are all fine. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat, sa ating mga OFWs, sa ating mga friends sa iba pong bansa, as well as doon po sa ating mga brethren na ngayon po ay nasa kanilang mga maybe sa trabaho po nila, maybe sa bahay. But what's important is that sa pamagitan po ng platform na ito ay magkaroon po tayo ng access para po magkaroon ng interaction. At through this kind of platform na niloob ng Diyos, through technology, na kahit po tayo po hindi magkakasama sa isang lugar, ay still pwede po tayo magkaroon ng Bible study. Okay, so ngayon po ay bago po tayo magsimula, nais ko lamang po na kayo po ay anyayahan sa isang maikling panalangin. Let us pray. Our Father in Heaven, Lord, salamat po Panginoon for your blessing, Lord, sa hapong ito. Pangunahan niyo po kami sa panibagong aklat na aming po pag-aaralan. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay po. So hello kay Sister Amy and kay Sister Annie Hermoso Alderete. And we have also Sister Melody. Okay? So ngayon po ay punta na po tayo sa introduction natin. Introduction. The second epistle of Paul the Apostle to Timothy. So the second epistle of Paul to Timothy is what is known as a swan song, an expression coming from the Reformation to indicate the sound of swan is supposed to make before it dies. This last utterances of Paul to his spiritual son in the faith in 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 2. So tignan po natin, no? Yung kung saan in-address ni Paul ang kanyang aklat, no? So 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse number 2. Unto Timothy, my son, in the faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and Jesus Christ our Lord. Okay, so nakita po natin na ito po yung address sa kanyang son in the faith. So spiritual son in the faith. Okay, so these last utterances of Paul to his spiritual son in the faith take their place alongside his speech to the Ephesians elders in Acts chapter 20. The Lord Jesus last discourses to his disciples in John chapter 13 to 17, Jacob's farewell to his 12 sons in Genesis 49, Joshua's final address to the children of Israel in Joshua 24, the last Psalms written by David in 2 Samuel 22 to 23, and especially the Song of Moses and his prophecies given in Deuteronomy 32 to 33 before God took him up to Nebo in Mount Pisgah. So this book, right, can be equal to this last discourses, huh? At makita po natin na napakahalaga po itong aklat nito. Hindi lamang po sa mga believers, kundi po sa mga leaders ng mga churches. And I'll give you the reason later. 2 Timothy was written near Paul's death when he was beheaded under the reign of Nero. So he was beheaded. Ang kinamatay kasi ni Paul ay he was beheaded, no? Siya ay pinugutan ng ulo. And that was King Nero, no? Or Emperor Nero of Rome. So siya po ay pinatay ng isang Roman emperor. And the reason why that happened because he stood for the faith. Second Timothy would be written around 68. That would be 2 years before the destruction of Jerusalem by Titus. No? The book has four chapters, 83 verses, and 1,666 words. It falls into four chapters that contain negative warnings and some admonitions and exhortations. It deals with the last days of the church, chapter 3, verse number 1, the last days of the church. All right, ito po sabi ng Bible dito, this know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. So it was written for that purpose. Ito po ay sinulat para sa last days ng church. So this book then is a special epistle along with Colossians that needs to be preached at the end of the church age. So ito ay kasama, no? Kamatsmit ng Colossians pag pinag-usapan yung importance, yung value, sapagkat ito po ay direct sa mga church age saints sa last days. Okay. In chapter 4, there is a warning to endure to finish in the race for the Lord. Okay, so chapter 4, you will see the last chapter. Ito po ay hamon, no, sa lahat po ng mga mananampalataya to endure to the end, to the finish line in the race that we are running for the Lord. Okay, now, so you can also connect that to Hebrews 12, verse 1 to 2. And 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24 to 27, yung pong last chapter ng 2 Timothy. So, kahambing po ito ng kanyang sinulat sa 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24 to 27, as well as Hebrews 12, verse 1 and 2. No, yun pong, yung last chapter nito is that binibigyan tayo ng challenge to continue running and continue running ultimately to finish our race. Second Timothy prophesies the apostasy in the body of Christ, as led by the faculty members and staffs of higher Christian education in Christian colleges, universities, and seminaries between 1900 and 2008, and up to now, to the present time. Okay? Now let's move to chapter 1. Paul's happy remembrance of Timothy and his family. That would be verse number 1 up to verse 7. And I'm going to read. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, according to the promise of life, which is in Christ Jesus. You take note of that preposition, in, before Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus. So we have all the blessings that we can get spiritually if we are in Christ. No, importante po yung word na yun, in Christ. Because sabi ng Bible dito, according to the promise of life, at yung promise of life na yun ay na kay Christ Jesus. No? So you cannot get that life without Jesus Christ. To Timothy, my dearly beloved son, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Okay? So this verse in verse number 2, it shows here that the token always of Paul's letters is here. Yung pong word na grace. Okay, grace. That's is always, yan ang word na kanyang, palaging nasa kanyang mga letters. Okay, to Timothy, my dearly beloved son. So the word son here is not the physical son, but a spiritual son. Son in the faith. Grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. So we have here God the Father, so, and Christ Jesus our Lord. So God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord are different, no? They are in the Godhead, but they are different. So God the Father is not the Son, and the Son is not God the Father. But God the Son is Jesus Christ is Son, is God, and the Father is God. Okay, so that is the essence of Trinity. Verse number 3, I thank God whom I serve from my forefathers with pure conscience, that without ceasing I have remembrance of thee in my prayers night and day. So that's how important is Timothy to Paul. So sabi niya, I have remembrance of thee in my prayers. So every time siya po nagpe-pray, ay binabanggit niya ang pangalan ni Timothy. So he is always praying for Timothy. And remember this time, okay, ay nasa prison na si Paul. And he's doing his best is still to do something for the Lord, and that is to pray for Timothy. Okay, now verse number 4, greatly desiring to see thee, being mindful of thy tears, and I may be filled with joy. So now you will see that because of their not just their suffering or hardships or trials that they are facing, why they are in tears. These tears are the emotion that involves for a good friend or mentor or father. Sabi niya, greatly desire to see thee, being mindful of thy tears. So Timothy is really longing with tears. May luhan is longing for the personal meeting, yung pagkikita muli nila ni Paul. So that's how they are so close to each other. Verse 4, greatly desiring to see thee, being mindful of thy tears, that I may be filled with joy. So they are longing for the day, pang sa ganun sabi niya, para tayo maging masaya o maligaya, joy. When I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice. And I am persuaded that in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance, that thou stir up the gift of God which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. So Paul is remembering the unfeigned faith of Timothy, in which he said that which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois. So it is from his grandmother, Timothy's grandmother, na nag-start yung faith na yon, yung unfeigned faith. Ibig sabihin ng unfeigned, ibig sabihin hindi siya fake, no? Say real, genuine. So meron siyang genuine at real na faith itong grandmother niya. At ipinasa ito sa kanyang anak, no? Si Eunice, and then ipinasa naman kay Timothy. And that's the reason why si Timothy, nakilala niya ang Panginoon ng maaga. No? Sabi ng Bible sa 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse number 15, that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. So it means malaking tulong at gabay ang ginawa ng mag-ina para sa buhay ng kanyang anak, no? Either apo o anak. So napakagandang halimbawa ito para sa atin. So ang family can support each other so that a person or a member of a family can grow spiritually. Huwag nating pababayaan ang sino man na nasa loob ng ating pamamahay na naiiwan siya. So dapat po magtulungan tayo. So yung growth, spiritual growth ay ma-achieve. Just like what happened here with Timothy, no? So meron siyang grandmother at meron siyang mother na tumulong sa kanya para makilala niya ang Panginoon at ma-establish siya sa tamang doktrina. Okay? So now, wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. So you can check that sa verse 14, that good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost which dwelleth in us. So he is now referring to a spiritual gift na ibinigay ng Diyos kay Timothy. Sabi niya, therefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God. So enhance that, make it grow, make it develop, so it will be more effective, which is indeed by the putting on of my hands. For God hath given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. So this should be memorized. Alam niyo po, napakalaga ito sa ating panahon, lalong-lalo na po sa situation natin ngayon, na palagi nating alalahanin na may Diyos na nagbibigay sa atin ng lakas ng loob, ng kapangyarihan, ng tunay na pag-ibig at maayos na pag-iisip. A sound mind. So we should have a stable mind, we should be have a strong spirit, we should not be dwelling in fear. You should be dwelling in the courage that God can give, as well as your trust must always be there. Kaya nga ito dapat i-memorize ng mga mananampalataya, di ba? Sabi ng Bible dito, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. That is what we need today. A strong fighting spirit. Hindi po yung madali tayong mag-give up. We are in a challenging time, no? Itong panahon natin, mga kapatid, ito yung panahon na dapat matatag ka. Ito yung panahon na hindi ka dapat kaagad-agad bumibitaw. At tandaan natin, hindi tayo bibitawan ng Diyos. No? Hanggat tayo naglilingkod sa Panginoon, God will give us the spirit of courage and power and love and sound mind. So this is a very good verse for every one of us. Okay, this is under a review of Paul's ministry. Verse number 8 to verse 12. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God. So the word ashamed here is connected to the suffering. Kasi po during the time, lahat po ng mga Kristiyano, they are facing great trials in life. So hindi pa po ganun ka-liberty, kalaya, ka-free ang pangangaral ng salita ng Diyos. And marami pong mga hostile groups, marami pong against sa kanila, the Jews, the Gentiles, the governments, and even the whole empire is against Christianity. So sabi ni Paul, huwag ka mahiya kung merong afflictions na nangyayari. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord. Whenever you are suffering for Christ, you are raising the testimony of the Lord. And people must see that in our lives. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God. So you have to be willing to be part of any kind of negative circumstances that will cross your way whenever you are there in the ministry preaching the gospel or doing something for the Lord. Alam niyo po, hindi niyo maiiwasan ang mga bagay na kapag tapat ka sa Panginoon, naglilingkod sa Diyos, active ka naglilingkod sa Panginoon, you will see some problems and trials, persecutions, and there are things that will hinder you to move on and preach the gospel. Kaya nga, you have to expect what? Afflictions. And be partaker of the afflictions. Verse number 9, who hath saved us? The word who here, of course, that is the Lord. Okay? Sabi niya, who hath saved us and called us with an holy calling, not according to our works. So, salvation here is not according to our works. Salvation here is what? According to His own purpose and grace which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began. So this salvation is not based on man's work. Okay? Kaya nga po na-save tayo, not because we are good, we are saved, not because we are religious, we are saved not because we are helpful, we are saved by grace, not ourselves, but the grace of God. Now, this verse is also used by the Calvinists, na mga Calvinists, and they coupled this verse in verse number 4 of chapter 1 of Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 1, 4. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 4. Nakalagay po doon, kung inyo makikita, na ang pagpili, sabi ng Bible dito, chosen us. Chosen. The same word na chosen dito eh. Binanggit dito eh. Sabi niya, according he hath chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, we shall be holy and without blame before him in love. So the Calvinist interprets this that there are people who are already saved before the foundation of the world. Okay, and then they are going to join here, join this Ephesians 1:4-2 chapter 1 verse 9 para i-prove na may mga elected na before the foundation of the world. But they forgot this, that all these things is only possible if you are in Christ. Salvation, okay, is only if you are in Christ. It is only possible if you are in Christ. Eh, hindi pa naman ito pwedeng mangyari before the foundation of the world sapagat wala pa naman si Kristo na namatay sa krus, nilibing at nabuhay na maguli, at wala pa yung body of Christ na sino mang maliligtas ay magiging kabahagi dito. So, this is possible only when you are in Christ, because Christ is what? Eternal. Si Kristo, ang Diyos, ang Panginoong Jesus, ay eternal. So, He is the Alpha and Omega. So, if you are saved now, you are elected, you are chosen before the foundation of the world. So, you are not chosen bago ka papasok kay Kristo. You are only chosen when you are in Christ. Okay, verse number 10. But is now made manifest by the appearing, made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who hath abolished death and hath brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Okay. So, kita natin, sabi ng Bible, yung word na appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, the word appearing here is, of course, sa ating mga believers na nasa church age, it is connected to the resurrection of our body in the rapture. But it's now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, at siya, sabi ng Bible, hath abolished it. Abolished niya ang kamatayan and hath brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. So if we are saved by the gospel, of course, we are going to live forever without death, and we have what? An immortality, a body that will never grow old. Okay? Now, you can check Titus chapter 1, verse 2 and 3 with this. In verse, yung verse 10. Titus chapter 1, verse 2 and 3, in hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world began, who hath in due times manifested his word through preaching, which is committed unto me according to the commandment of God our Savior. See the word? Which God that cannot lie promised before the world began. Okay. Now, whereunto I am appointed a preacher and an apostle and a teacher of the Gentiles. Ito po yung position ni Paul sa mga Gentiles. Sabi niya, I am appointed a preacher, isang tagapangaral, and an apostle, sent one, and a teacher of the Gentiles. For the which cause I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that neither that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. This verse is also a very good verse to memorize. No? Maganda pong i-memorize po ito. Sinasabi po dito, for the which cause, oh, I also suffer these things, nevertheless, I am not ashamed. For I know whom I have believed, and I'm persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Kaya, the closest meaning of that day, is when you're going to appear with Christ in rapture. I have committed unto him against that day. Okay, now, Paul's admonition to Timothy. Ito yung kanyang admonition sa kanyang son in the faith. Verse number 13. Hold fast the form of sound words which thou hast heard of me in faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. Again, lumitaw po yung salitang in Christ Jesus. Sabi niya, hold fast the form of sound words. Ano po yung hawakan niya? Maigpit. It is the word of God. No? The form of sound words. Yung sound means tama, no? Or maayos. The form of sound words. So, if you're going to check sa ating panahon, especially by looking on the other versions of the Bible, since we are Bible believers, so we can check this kind of false Bibles operating and siya yung mas promoted at growing in publishing. But check this one. Both versions right now, okay, sila yung nagbabiolate dito eh. You know why? Because they don't hold fast the form of sound words. There is no sound words in those translations. NIV, ERSB, AB, what's it? American Bible, pero po yun eh. We have the NASB or the ASB. And many other modern versions, they don't hold fast the form of sound words. Because if you're going to check the inside, the content of those so-called holy Bible, you will see that it's no more holy. The main violators of this commandment are the translators and revisers of the new version. And you can get a copy, that will be good for a New Age Bible versions written by Gail Riplinger. So he's now exposing things that are, you know, yung gawa ni Satan inside the modern verses. So Gail Riplinger is a very good teacher as well as a very good writer sa mga ganitong klaseng mga area, especially sa translations sa King James Bible. For some of the sound words, they get rid of. Yun ang ginawa ng mga violators. Yun ang ginawa ng mga modern versions. They get rid of. Inalis po nila yung mga sound words. Actually, hindi lang po words, kundi buong verse. Huh? Sa Mark chapter 6, verse 9 to 20, almost the whole chapter. Nilagyan nila ng question mark. Okay, so the violators of this verse, in chapter 1 verse 13, are the people who subscribe to modern versions. Verse 14, that good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost which dwelleth in us. So the good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost which dwelleth in us. So merong kinumit si Paul, no? Merong pinagkalob siya, which was committed, para bang in-entrust sa kanya, no? The good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost, which dwelleth in us. Now, the last four verses, Okay, yung verse, okay, let's go to verse 15. This thou knowest that all, so this is under Paul recalls the visits of Onesiphorus. Verse 14, 15. This thou knowest that all they which are in Asia turn away from me, of whom are Phygelus and Hermogenes. The Lord give mercy unto the house of Onesiphorus, for he oft repressed me and was not ashamed of my chain. So you see the word there, chain. So that means that Paul is in prison, and actually is now, okay, he was chained and he is now going to be killed. So hindi lang po siya kinulong, he was chained also, and now he is ready for departure through decapitation. Pakahirap ang nangyari kay Paul. Pero tinanggap niya lang yon, lang lahat, willingly, dahil nakita niya kahalagahan ng salita ng Diyos at kahalagahan niya bilang pastor at missionary. But when he was, verse number 16, the Lord gave mercy unto the house of Onesiphorus, for he oft repressed me. The word oft means always. He oft repressed me, and I was and was not ashamed of my shame. But when he was in prison, he sought me out very diligently and found me. So, sabi ni Paul, Onesiphorus, that's somebody. That's a character. Why? Sabi niya, when he was in Rome, nang siya nasa Rome, he sought me out. Hinanap niya ako, sabi niya, very diligently and found me. Verse 18, the Lord grant unto him that he may find mercy of the Lord in that day. So that day is the judgment of Christ, as well as we can see dun po sa chapter 1 verse 12, sabi niya, unto him against that day. So that day is equivalent to the rapture and to the judgment seat of Christ. Okay. Ulitin po tayo sa verse 17, but when he was in Rome, he sought me out very diligently and found me. The Lord grant unto him that he may find mercy of the Lord in that day. And in how many things he ministered unto me at Ephesus, thou knowest very well. So, nakatago, may mga behind the scene na mga taong tumutulong sa mga leaders ng church. At isa na po dito si Onesiphorus. At ang sabi ng Bible, hinanap niya talaga ang kanyang kasamang manggagawa. But when he was in Rome, he sought me out very diligently and found me. The Lord grant unto him that he may find grace of the Lord in that day. And in how many things he ministered unto me at Ephesus, thou knowest very well. So, well commended itong si Onesiphorus. Okay, so hanggang doon lang po tayo mga kapatid. 2 Timothy chapter number 1. So, we have heard about this swan song, these final words of Paul to Timothy. Sa isa church. Okay? Parang isang general na magre-retire natin. Merong uusbong na panibagong general is going to put all the authority to the next person that will complete what he started and what is going to yung kanyang plan. Now Timothy is very important person in the Bible because it shows that through him it shows that we as believers, tayong mga ligtas, lalo na po mga leaders at yung mga namumuno ng church, we need to have Timothy in our lives. At maghanap po kayo ng Timothy. Bagaman hindi po siya lalaki, you can disciple him, you can help him grow. So, yun po ang kailangan natin sa ating panahon. We must have Timothy. So, para po mag-grow na mag-grow ang gawain ng ating Panginoon Diyos. Okay po, maraming salamat po mga kapatid sa ating pong natapos na chapter 1. Okay, so again, patingin ko lang po ang ating mga naging kasama ngayon. We have Sister Amy Estrella, Sister Annie Hermoso Alterete, Brother Levi Ceballos in Korea. We have Sister My Heart Rings Melody. Okay, Sister Melody po ito. Okay, and then we have Sister Nancy. And we have also a Brother Pastor Romeo Medida Navidad. Amen. Good afternoon po sa inyo. Pastor Alan. Keep it up. Okay. So we have also Brother Magnon Gomez Mandal. Okay. We have also Brother Patrick Solano. Amen, amen. And who else? Kasama natin ngayon. All right, good. So we have Honey Lee and Sister Rems Perez. Good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. So tandaan po natin, this book is addressed to Timothy, and his yung theme and message ng sinulat ni Paul, second epistle niya, is really for the church. And he is telling us in prophecy, okay, that he's telling us in prophecy that we must continue serving the Lord. Okay, because we are already in the last days. Okay po. So tayo po ay manalangin, nagkilang Diyos. Paunahan niyo po kami sa aming naging pag-aaral. Thank you for the blessing. Thank you for the wisdom that you have given us. Bless us, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, amen. Praise God. Amen, amen, amen. Okay po. God bless po at magandang hapon po sa inyo. God is good all the time, all the time. God is good.